going on this morning, folks? It's Tyler T coming at you this morning. We at the old home place. Unfortunately, we knocked the wind out of our 309 due to a small mishap. This is Barnett and Sons on the how to and how not to install the replacement window for a 309 cat excavator.
I was having trouble with that one.
Right now, just trying to take off this rubber gasket, rubber seal, and the window basically just glues right back in.
Well, that's cutting right out of there for you. So we got our new window from Cat.
Yep.
Where did they go right in here?
What do they look like?
Them seals right here, the tennis. What they got right here? Right there. This right here is them two bolts that you take out on the sliding mechanism.
I think we could just put some of that adhesive right on top of the other stuff, you know.
Get the majority of it off.
Did it come with a gasket?
No, that's that adhesive. Mm-hmm. That's all that window was stuck to. That's that stuff. And son, it sticks. It's that roller reverse is bent. And you can kind of look down this bar and see it's bent.
Yep.
But it slid up and down through her.
It ain't going to when the window gets on it. It's got to be straightened out so the window lays on it correctly.
And I think this little thing right here is bent too. I don't know if that's going to affect the way it rolls or... Is it recording?
Yeah.
Alright, folks, we're getting down to the nitty gritty here. We're about to lay the glue to it. Yeah, there you go.
I got the window.
Okay.
I'm gonna leave it down to you once you get under there. And you just can get it kindly placed.
Uh-huh. Alright, I'll let go up here on my side.
I'm letting go of it, boys. I got it. Ho, ho, ho. You uns got it?
Yep.
I don't believe you do.
Yeah, we did.
Okay.
Now?
Yeah. Toward me, Ty. There, oh, I see. Okay, I got mine straight across through here, I think. You just have to, as it pushes that wood out, just kind of push the wood back in. Just hold on.
All right, we're just gonna let it dry right here and take her over to the job and put her on. All right, folks, we got our window in, our 309. We're laying a pressure washer to them right now, and it looks like it held up pretty good, so. What you can do is you can clean the excess off with a knife after you get it. You can just cut the excess off. But it's a machine, so I ain't really worried about how pretty it's looking. I got our two 305s pressure washed. Just happen to have three machines at our house today, so worked out that we could get them pressure washed, and we changed the oil in this one here and the fuel filter on it. This is my worker down here. I just hired him a few days ago. So the two bolts for the that I was talking about and that was holding, they go right here. One goes right there. And the other one goes in the same spot on the other side. And there's no bolt on over here. It's got threads in there. All right, guys. All right, I'm just gonna sneak this in at the end of the 309 video. We bought us a new trailer here. It's a 2000 model gooseneck trailer. It is made by A&A Welding Service. It is a 12,000 pound trailer. It's got two 6,000 pound axles, single tire. Cool thing about this trailer is if you're pulling it with a truck like this one, the GVWR on this truck is only 12,000. So for the trailer and the truck, it is 24,000, and in Tennessee it's 26,000 1 pound. Combined GVWR weight is you're required to have your CDLs to pull it. So that's the cool thing about this trailer. We can have guys move equipment around, smaller pieces of equipment like these, with this trailer here. So we're gonna get a little bit of pulling in with it today. We already got a short video loading the skid steer up on it. And today I think we're gonna load some furniture up on it. So the trailer's got a little bit of surface rust. I think for the majority of its life, it's kind of just set around. But for the most part, I've been underneath the trailer. Everything is solid. It's just got surface rust on it. We're thinking about maybe sanding it down, sandblasting it, painting it. a pretty view here in the valley. Up to the home place up here, headquarters. Gonna pick up little brother and his woman and head down to Jefferson City, go get some beds and furniture. Have no clue what's going on here. Got it loaded with a few things here. mattress, some bed stuff, dresser. Since this is a shorter trailer, we're gonna let little brother get some experience in driving. You ready for this? Stay wide, keep it that way. Come through here, you see, you covered it, cleared it good. Now, stop right here. We also put new 14-ply tires on this puppy. The ones it had on it when we bought it was, they were kind of dry rotted and they were only 10-ply tires. And with the weight that we haul on it, we kind of maxed it out. So we wanted to put some more heavier duty tires on it. I'll give you an idea on the clearance on this gooseneck. We've got it adjusted to the lowest hole, or not the lowest, the one before the lowest on the bed, so it kind of evens out back there at the beaver tail. We'll load it up on the video, yeah.
That's what I mean, like while you're videoing?
Yeah.
Like right now or what?
Yeah. Okay. Hey, Ty. What happened to that?
I painted up a little bit and I was re-counting over.
This is loud. Trying to fix the rake, he bent it up.
No, I just made it better.
He just made it better.
I don't know why it's out of the toolbox.
A little bit of a tight turn here. So, I was pulling this trailer the other day, and when I hit my brakes for the first time after getting it loaded and hooked up, it came off the ball and the truck geared down to help stop me, and it been in my toolbox and shattered my back glass. We're having a problem with our lock right there. It wasn't all the way down on the in the lock, so it came off and crumbled my toolbox and shattered my back glass. But maybe that'll be our next video, replacing the glass in this back window. I got it ordered on Amazon. I got the one with the sliding middle section instead of the solid glass all the way through, so. All right.